Welcome back to Pure Science Education. Today we'll be looking at element compound and mixture. This topic comes up at Gcse 3 and GCSE exam. Let's look at what elements are. Before we do that, all materials are made out of chemicals. Chemicals can be divided into living and non-living objects. Why are chemicals so important? So, different chemicals are made of different elements. Let's look at what an element is. An element is a pure substance which cannot be simplified and is made out of one type of atom only. So let's write that down. So elements are pure substances made of one type of atom only. This particular point here is what they are looking for if you're doing a GCSE exam. That's a definition of an element. It cannot be simplified. As it's in its pure state. So, if you look at the periodic table, for example, all of them are elements on that. So, if you can see on here, I've got sodium, magnesium, potassium, calcium. If I was to take sodium and break it down, then every single atom of that would be of sodium, same as magnesium and calcium, and so and so no matter which element you take, it's made out of one type of atom only, and whichever element you break down, that's what you're gonna get. Now these, if you look at these things here, they are called symbols. So these are the symbols for the elements that are found on the periodic table. Mg is magnesium, Na is sodium, K is potassium, C is calcium, Fe is iron, H is hydrogen, O is oxygen, and so on. At room temperature, elements can be solid, liquid, or gas. So, can be solid, liquid, or gas. As at room temperature, and again, if you look at hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and gases, if you then look at carbon, it's a solid. So different things will have different melting and boiling points depending on the state. Now, chemicals are elements are really being seen because they bond to become a compound. So, what is a compound? So, if you look at a compound is when two or more elements are chemically bonded together. Again, if you're writing this down for your exams for GCSE, that's the definition the exam would be like. If you was to then look at these examples, so if you look at the first one, water, it's a compound because it's got hydrogen and oxygen elements in there, and the ratio is 2:1, so you got 2 hydrogen and 1 oxygen. If we look at ammonia, it's got nitrogen and hydrogen in there. Again, it's a compound because it's made of nitrogen and hydrogen. If you look at this one here, carbon dioxide, it's made of carbon and oxygen. Finally, hydrogen peroxide is made of hydrogen and oxygen. So again, compounds are where you got elements that are chemically bonded. So chemically bonded means they cannot be physically separated. So Let's look at how to work out which compound has how many elements and atoms. So again, at a GCSE exam, you need to be able to count number of atoms and elements in a compound. So if you look at H2O water, for example, and if I asked you how many elements it had, the answer will be 2. If I then ask you how many atoms it has, the answer will be 3. So where do I get the 3 from? So I've got 2 hydrogens and 1 oxygen. That gives me the 3. Similarly, if I look at hydrogen peroxide, elements equals 2, but atoms equals 4, because I've got 2 oxygen and 2 hydrogen. So you can work out how within a compound how many elements and atoms you have. So again, another GCSE question. Please be careful when you're working this out and do not get confused. And finally, let's look at mixtures. So here you got a mixture of iron and sulfur. So what's the difference between a mixture? Mixture is made of 2 or more elements not chemically bonded. So again, in terms of exam, this is the definition you're looking at. You've got 2 or more elements that are not chemically bonded, they become a mixture. So if you look at this example of iron and sulfur, I can separate my iron because iron here is magnetic. So what it leaves behind is the sulfur. In terms of powder, a magnetic iron can be taken out. So this is not chemically bonded, they've physically been added together and then can be separated as shown in the picture. So it's easy to separate mixtures. So if you got a pack of Skittles, you got all different colors or shapes, then you can just put them into different shapes or color category and then again separate them out because they're not bonded together. Now, in terms of mixtures, they tend to need separating, just as shown in the example above. There are different types of separation techniques which you need to know for your exams. So these separation techniques are evaporation, filtration, distillation, fractional distillation, and chromatography. Now, each of these techniques are listed in your GCSE curriculum, and you should be able to explain each of these techniques and how do they work. So what I'll do in the next video, I'll go through each of these techniques and explain which technique is applied where and why, and how do they differ. So just a quick recap for today. An element is in its pure state, cannot be simplified, and all atoms in an element are exactly the same. Compound is 2 or more elements chemically bonded together, so once they're bonded they cannot be separated. And mixtures are two or more elements that are not chemically bonded together, and as shown by the list of techniques, they can be separated out of their when they're mixed together. I hope this was useful. Please like and subscribe, and thank you for joining me. Thank you.